Hello and welcome. In this video, we will be covering discrete event simulation, mathematical models, and recursive formulae. Discrete event simulations are used to model a system of activity or phenomenon. They use a series of components including entities, attributes, and events. Entities typically represent real-world objects that interact with one another. These entities have characteristics called attributes. The interactions between entities are called events. A discrete event simulation focuses on the state of the system at specific moments in time. This could be at a fixed time interval, or it could be whenever an event occurs. If a system being simulated can be represented by a mathematical formula, then we can model it in a spreadsheet like Excel. Suppose we want to simulate the repayment of a loan. How much is still owed after each payment? The loan is our entity. It has attributes, such as the principal, the initial amount of the loan, the interest charged on the loan, and a monthly repayment. We can calculate a formula to represent the amount we owe in the first month. This represents the initial amount of the loan, plus the interest for the month, minus the payment for that month. Factor out the amount, and we get this. We can then calculate a formula to represent the amount remaining for the second month, based on the amount for the first month. In fact, we can generalize this to represent the amount for any subsequent month, given the amount from the previous month. Note that this formula refers to itself. This means it's a recursive formula. Let's model this in Excel. Here, we have the initial loan, the monthly interest rate, based on 3% per year, and the monthly payment amount. Note also that we're using named cell references for clarity. First, we enter the formula for the first payment. Next, we enter the formula for the second payment. This is the recursive form of the formula. With that done, we can click and drag to fill down until we get a value of 0 or less. From this, we can see that it will take 21 months to pay off the loan, interest and all. This example was financial in nature, but discrete event simulations like this can be used to model other phenomena, such as biological development, chemical reactions, or even social interactions. Thanks for watching.